everyone, and welcome to Nicosia Cyprus. We're kicking off the second day of shotgun events here at the Nicosia Olympic Shooting Range, where we've gathered for Trap Men. I'm Hillary Russell and have the pleasure of having USA's trap shooter, Seth Inman, with me today. Welcome, Seth. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me, Hillary.
It's a windy day today. I'm kind of wondering, what do you think is going to happen during the semifinal and bronze medal and gold medal match? Do you think the wind's going to affect the targets greatly?
I believe it will. It seemed to pick up quite a bit this afternoon, and it was having some effect on the targets.
Well, just in a couple seconds, have a chance to introduce our finalists today. There was a three-way shoot-off for sixth place today, and which is not really that surprising with the talent that we've got. There they are, six finalists. We have in position one, representing Croatia, Giovanni Cerigorac.
Giovanni's been shooting very well the last year, won the Olympics. He's looking good today.
I wonder how much his life has changed since he's won the Olympics.
I'm sure he's been very busy.
In position two, representing the Czech Republic, we have Yuri Liptak.
I followed Yuri earlier yesterday, and he was moving the gun very well.
In position three, representing Croatia, we have Josip Glasnovic.
Also followed Josip, and he was shooting very well, moving the gun well.
We have two guys in there from Croatia today, so
yes.
Could be a banner day for both of them.
Could be.
In position four, representing Slovakia, we have Eric Varga.
He shot a fantastic score. I didn't get a chance to watch him shoot, but fantastic shooting.
In position five, representing Australia, we have Michael Diamond.
Michael had a great day today and recovered after a bad first round for him. But great day today.
And in position six, representing the Russian Federation, we have Alexei Alipov.
A flank for Alexei today. He was moving the gun outstanding, so should be a strong shoot-off for the final.
So we're going to be going into the semifinal. You want to talk to us a little bit about what we're expecting to see here?
The semifinal consists of 15 targets from stations 2, 3, and 4. The first three will shoot, and then they rotate back and for a total of 15, and then your top four go on from there. Maybe not if they're shoot-offs, they could shoot off, but third and fourth will shoot for the bronze medal match, and then first and second will shoot for the gold medal match. But it one shot final, and That's pretty much it.
Just to keep in mind for the viewers that after qualifications, all six finalists enter with a score of zero.
That's right.
It's really, really anybody's game.
That's right.
You know, and if you just miss one target from the beginning, you go right down to sixth place.
Yeah.
You know?
It's a tough new system to deal with, and it's had some.
It's had its effect. And have you had a chance to actually play around with this and with the U.S. team?
Yes, we did some training camps with it. You know, we've done some small matches and shoot it and see how it goes. And it's about 50-50 good and bad on it
right.
with us. So.
Well, I think change in general is really difficult for a lot of people. I can say it is for me as well. And so maybe after a little while, maybe some of the little nooks and crannies are sealed up a little bit better, then things could take on a new look. So far, we're starting off really, really well. No one has missed a target so far.
They're underway.
Ready. And let's just focus in now on Varga. Oof. You know, we were talking about that the chance of shoot-offs after the semifinal. It's highly, highly probable because of the talent that we have here.
Absolutely. This is a great squad.
And what we saw yesterday during the women's trap event was the two women got into such a groove, into their own routine, and we were here for a really, really long time. So it could be like that again, Seth. You might be sitting here with me until the sun goes down.
That's all right. Yes, very talented squad.
Now, Croatia seems to be having showing that they've got a really, really strong team. You know, with two of their gentlemen entered into the final.
One of them, they know,
with the gold.
Miss there, man.
Okay, the wind is picking up quite a bit. Seth and I are basically have a bird's eye view of the shooting range. And so we're on top of the hill, and you can see it's not really grass, but it's some type of greenery that
it's
is.
That's alfalfa,
yes. Okay. Thank you. You can see this great alfalfa patch in front of the shooting range, and it's really moving around quite fast.
Yes, it has been since about noon today, so it's. Another loss for Varga.
So, tell us a little bit about qualifications today. Because you had them yesterday and you had them today.
Yes, less windy today, and the weather's been really good other than the wind. It's been very, very warm, about 95 degrees Fahrenheit. But the targets have seemed to be...
There's a miss there from Michael Diamond.
For as windy as it is, I guess being down in this bowl, the targets don't seem to be too... Another one.
This is what happens if you start saying something. Generally, what happens is you get a miss.
The left seem to be rising quite a bit, and you're getting a push on the rights because we've got a left-to-right wind. So,
in fact, yesterday we had a left-to-right wind, and then all of a sudden, halfway through, it went the other direction. You know, and then it switched back again. So, we were seeing a lot of targets going down. There we go. Chernogratz coming back into the game with a hit. Lipcat coming off a hit with a miss with a hit. And Glasnevich.
Screen looking solid.
And this is what you were talking about before. What we just saw happen is that the three from behind come up and take over and shoot from there, which is a completely different method than what anyone was used to from the past years.
Yes.
Oh! Nice. Diamond's hitting that squarely. So let's take a look at the standings and see what's happening after this third shot. Glasnevich is tied up with Varga, and we have Chernogratz and Diamond tied up for third, and also Liptak tied up for third place, and Alipov is in sixth place. But you know, so early into the semifinal that things could turn around, especially with the way the wind is going. And but let's just talk for a second about this shooting range. What do you think about it?
I think it's outstanding. I shot here a long, long time ago, back in 2001, and the wall wasn't there at the time.
Oops.
Back on it. You see the target very well out of the bunker here. Very well.
Glasnevich is just having a fantastic beginning to this final.
Yes, he is.
Ready. And on to Varga, who is 3 for 3 at the moment. Oh. Beautiful. Just so you all know, the wind has subsided right now. We're having a little bit of a lull as well.
Target.
So no target there for Diamond. Ready. Oh. I love the fact that Diamond, you know, all the, your shooters have these special glasses for shooting, and they can change the lenses and everything. And he just goes in with a pair of Ray-Bans and, you know, calls it a day.
We were talking about that the other night, and he come across them somewhere, and he's gonna stick with them. I guess he left his at home one time or forgot them or something. I don't know what he was saying, but he really likes those, I guess.
Well, they seem to work for him. He sent it up in today's final. All right, back on to Chernogratz coming off of a miss. And that's another miss. Lip tack. Getting back in the game, just missing one throughout today's final so far, and on to Glasnovic.
Shooting well.
Really great. Also Varga having a perfect final. Onto Diamond. Diamond, during the London Games, he just came in fourth place, just missing the podium. So I'm sure that he's really pretty psyched up the season to improve and improve, and you know, never know how it's going to end up for him.
I believe he made the final in Acapulco too, so he's having a good year. And did he medal in Acapulco?
I do not believe that he did. Let me just take a look quickly.
No, he did not.
No. Okay, Chernogratz coming off of two misses. Great, with a hit.
Oh.
A hit also for Liptak. Glasnovic, let's see if he can keep into the zone that he's in right now. And
he's
looking
good.
Back on to Varga.
Whoa.
Unbelievable. Great shooting.
Oh!
Oh, missed from Diamond. He's recovered well.
He has a way of making it look very easy, you
yes,
know?
Yes, he does.
Let's just take a look at the standings now. We still have a two-way tie for first place between Glasnovic and Varga. Liptak is holding on to third by himself. Diamond has moved down into fourth, tied up with Alipov, and Chernogratz is holding on to sixth place.
Still anybody's game, though.
Oh, yeah. I wonder how it must feel for Chernogratz, the pressure after winning the Olympic Games, to perform well. It must be quite a pressure to have on your shoulders.
I'm sure. I would think so. With all the tension, and you want to keep the level. I can't speak for him, but for me, I would be under a lot more pressure to keep performing at that level. And he shot fantastic at the Olympics.
He certainly did.
And he seems to be performing at that level still, so.
Okay, back on now to Varga. Varga, who placed fourth in Alain just recently. Okay, Diamond getting back into the zone. You know, between Alipov and Diamond, I bet you could fill a very large building with all the medals that they have won.
Yes, they've been dominating for several years.
They get on to Liptak. Making it look very easy once again. The wind has picked up just a little bit. You can see the dust from the targets just kind of moving off of the field of play. Pretty fast rate. And as I say that, the wind shuts down.
It didn't take long for the dust to get up here, though.
No, it didn't at all. In fact, it was strange. It kind of looked like the wind was coming at the shooters right now and then kind of moved up.
Swirling a bit.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's because we're down in this bowl here a little bit.
Yeah.
Parker's looking very solid.
Nice shot by Michael Diamond. Alipov had a little hiccup there at the beginning, but he really seems to have gotten into his own zone there and is doing phenomenally.
Recovered very well.
There's another one that gets away from Chernogoratz.
Oh.
Nice hit there by Liptak and Glasnevich, who is shooting a perfect final with another hit. He looks like he's just not touchable.
Looking great. I followed him on his first round yesterday, and he was very solid. Him and Liptak both, but.
Okay, and Varga, who also is looking like he's untouchable today. Beautiful.
Great shot. Hard target with the wind pushing it.
Oh.
Oh.
And that one just got away from Diamond. Let's take a look now at Alipov. Okay, and once again, the standings are going to show that Glasnevich and Varga are still tied up 9 out of 9 hits, and Liptak is in third place. Alipov is holding on to fourth place. Diamond has moved down into fifth, and Chernogoratz is still holding on to sixth place.
Still pretty tight. And with this wind, who knows what could happen?
Anything could happen, I think. Okay. Like Chernogoratz has gotten back into the game. Oh. And Liptak, really, you said that you were following him yesterday and he was shooting really well. He's having a really, really great final. He's moved up the scoreboard. And let's focus back in onto Glasnevich. He seems like he's gotten into a rhythm all of his own.
Yes, they shot together in their pre-qualification, so they've been shooting together since they got here.
Nice.
Still going.
Shooting a perfect final. Back onto Diamond, coming off the rest with a hit. Nice.
Great move. That was a hard right there.
For you, which angle of the target is the hardest for you?
I believe about a 1 meter right off the ground, and 45 degree right is pretty much the hardest target for a right hand shooter, I believe.
Okay. So do you practice that shot all the time or?
Quite a bit.
Quite a bit, yeah.
Well, that was a high target. The wind's really starting to push.
Now, mentally, let's just talk about Chernogoratz for a minute. Mentally, after missing the amount of targets that he's missed so far, do you think that it's hard to get back into it, or do you think that probably someone of his level, he has had mental training and things like that, but could there be something in the back of your head just saying, what's going wrong here?
I'm sure he's probably trying to keep the same mental game, even though I'm missing. I don't, don't ever give up.
Right.
Just keep on going and... Yeah, I'm sure he's had mental training. We all have, and it's hard to deal with, and the wind could be causing it, it's hard to, you can get out of focus if you're missing quite a few, but I'm sure he'll finish up strong.
Like some of these shooters, especially yesterday, what I noticed is that sometimes from these cameras that we have on the ground, looking up at the shooters, you can see when the doubt enters into their eyes and you think, okay, that's it. They've lost their concentration. And, 9 out of 10 times is exactly what happens.
Yes.
Where you see some of the shooters, especially some shooters from China, they don't show any emotion whatsoever. So you really don't know, what they're thinking, how they're feeling. Okay, back on now to Liptak. Definitely holding on to third place.
He doesn't waste any time.
He certainly doesn't. Glasnevich.
He's shooting an excellent final. Excuse me, semi. final.
That's fine, thank you.
Ready.
And Bard is still straight also, so.
He's the slowest of them, all the men to shoot. You know, I guess everybody has their own routine, but there we go. Diamond with another hit. And back on now to Alipov. So we've got three more targets to go, Seth, and we've got Glasnevich and Vargas still with a perfect score of 12 out of 12, tied up for first place. Liptak holding on to third place by one target advantage over Alipov. Diamond is down fifth place, and Chernogoratz is in sixth place. So, you know, Diamond's really got to put the pressure on in order to stay in this. If not, after the semifinal, Diamond and Chernogoratz would be eliminated.
Yes.
But that's with three targets to go. Anything can happen in three targets.
Anything could happen. We got a banner squad here, and they're all tough. So anything can happen, mm-hmm. I believe.
Liptak is gonna just still hold on to third place with that hit, and Glasnevich. Unbelievable shooting. Hit for Varga. Back on out of Diamond. Nice hit there by Diamond. And Alipov. Yeah.
Great job.
Two more targets to go to find out who's going to be in the bronze and who's going to be in the gold medal matches.
Ready.
He seemed to be showing the same composure as the Olympics, though. I mean, the same routine. Mm-hmm. Everything looks the same.
I suppose you can't be on the highest of the podium all the time, you know?
Oh, Liptak.
Liptak just let that one go.
Glasnevich is still solid. Good.
He really is, you know. I was trying to find out the last time that he was on the podium, and that was in 2010. He won the silver World Cup medal in Lunato, and so I think that he's striving to get right back up there on the podium. Varga also perfect final. Back now onto Diamond. Nice.
Good shot. Alipov has recovered well from his first three.
He certainly has.
Ready.
We've got one more target to go. And the way that Glasnevich and Varga have been shooting, it would not surprise me at all if they're going to be going at it neck to neck for the gold. Nice
team.
Deck. Finishing off with a hit.
Well, perfect semifinal. Great shooting.
I'm just going to have to wait now for Varga to see if he can just do the same thing as Glasnevich did. That will seal the deal without a doubt for the gold medal match.
Matters,
I don't think so either.
He's gonna make it in.
It would have been nice for him to finish off with a perfect semifinal, but you know, he really shot like a star throughout the whole thing. So
absolutely.
And Alipov finishing off strong. Let's just take a look and see what the scores have. And in fact, as you were saying, we are going to have Glasnevich and Varga going into the gold medal match. But first, we've got Liptak and Alipov that are going to be going into the bronze medal match. Unfortunately, we're going to have to say goodbye to Michael Diamond, who is finishing off in fifth place.
In the bronze medal.
Okay, so it looks like we're going to get into this bronze medal match now. Now, once again, just to remind everybody, all the scores from the semifinal are now erased once again. We're starting with zero again. So
yes.
The bronze could go to anyone. The bronze medal match probably is the most difficult one out of the two because one person's going home with a medal and the other one is not going home with.
Absolutely.
You know, they're going home with the experience of making it to the semifinal, which is, you know, huge in itself. But but yeah.
Oh, there we go.
And here we go. Flip tap, starting off on the right foot.
And the wind is still howling.
Now, if you could put your money on either one of these guys, it's a hard one, I'd have to say.
Yuri was in front of me yesterday and shot fantastic. He ran the 50 yesterday, and then Alexei followed me all day today, and he looked really solid. I flanked his last round, and he ran 25, and
it's a hard one to call.
I mean,
really.
He shot a 123. I mean, it's just, it is going to be a hard one to call. So I can't put my money on either one of them.
I'm not asking you to become a betting man.
No, I am a gambling man, so. People back home will probably get a kick out of me saying that.
All right, so we're starting off very well. 2 out of 2 for both Liptak and Alipov.
Shooting very well for the wind conditions.
Actually, it's surprising. I'm curious to know what it would be like down there, but I, you know, maybe we're feeling a little bit more being, you know, basically perched on the side of this cliff here, looking down.
It's not as bad down there, I think. You know, it comes down the chute here and it could mess with them a little bit. You're just getting a push on your right targets. It might pick the speed of them up a little bit or drive them to the ground, and your lefts are going to go up a little bit more. But other than that, they seem to be not as affected as most places, really, with the wind. It was kind of surprising today, even shooting.
All right, 3 out of 3 for both Liptak and Alipov. I always like to watch the pre-shot routine of everyone. So everyone's completely different, obviously, and but it's amazing how it's so precise, shot after shot after shot. The same thing, even with like wiping your hand on your shoulder or, you know, pushing the glasses up in a certain way.
Try to do the same thing every time.
Yeah.
Every time, even. Wiping your hands off, all that, like you were saying, that you try to do everything the same every time, 25 times, for the most part.
All right, these guys are shooting very strong, 4 out of 4.
Oh, oops. The tarp's blowing in front of the bunker. I don't know if that distracted him or.
You are distracted or whatever, that's the right thing to do, is to just set it down for a minute.
Absolutely. Start your routine over. And he nailed it.
Yeah. So now to Alipov. Perfect hit there. Now Alipov was a 2-time Olympic Games medalist. Gotta say, there's a little bit of expertise there.
Yes, he's been shooting well for years. He had a great match, or great qualification, and had a great semifinal after missing a couple early. So
that's
he's definitely in the groove.
You can always count on him coming back. You know, even if he misses a couple at the beginning, there's a couple of shooters, a handful of shooters out there that I've witnessed throughout the years that even if they have a really hard start, you can't give up on them.
Right.
Because something happens and all of a sudden they've climbed up into some of the highest positions on the scoreboard. We still have it tied up neck to neck, 6-6 for Liptak and Alipov.
Outstanding. Yeah, they're both looking really solid.
They look really solid, and I'm really surprised that, you know, with this win, that nothing more dramatic is happening.
Oh.
So just so everyone knows, if by chance these guys do, you know, perfect scores and. What was going to happen is that we go into a sudden death shoot-off.
Missing out.
And whoever misses first, obviously, is out.
The rate they're going, if they get into that, it could go a while.
It could, exactly. Exactly. That's why I said, you know, with this talent, you could be standing a chance of being here for quite a while tonight, Seth.
Oh, that's
and
okay.
And you were so great about saying yes to me today. You were riding the fence big time, and I could see your mind moving and moving.
Well, if I hadn't been away so long and known more about everybody, I wouldn't have been on the fence so much. The light's starting to get a little bit harder, not quite a shadow, but
a little bit hazy.
Yes.
A little bit. And so when it gets like this, what do the targets look like to you?
They start to shrink a little bit and they get shadows on them. I notice over here on one that the trees on the side are casting a shadow.
Oops. That's the first one that has gotten away from Liptak. This is definitely Alipov's time to shine if he can just keep on going forward, doing what he's been doing. He'll be going home with a bronze. Gosh, he can make that look so easy. I can't get over it. So there you go. We've got Liptak right now with 8 out of 9 targets, and Alipov shooting a perfect bronze medal match. Still with 6 targets to go, anything can happen. And like you're just saying, the light's changing, so.
Yep, this word about that shadow, I don't know how they're seeing it. I don't know if it's casting over. It's not casting over the bunker, but.
Nice.
Good shot.
Alipov is really fighting hard there for that bronze.
He's in the zone.
He certainly is. 5 more targets to go to find out who will be on the podium today and who will be going home in fourth place.
Oh.
Ooh.
Another miss from Liptak.
This is a tough target.
Nice. Alipov up by 2.
Four to go. You never know what's going to happen.
Mm-mm, you really don't.
He's just been in the groove since the first pass gave him a little trouble in the semi, but since then it's looking like his last round today, which was 25 first barrels, I believe.
Let me just ask you something, Seth. You know, I'm looking down at the bunker right now, and there's that green tarp that's covering, and every so often when wind catches it just right, and it looks like it gives a ripple effect.
Right.
Do you think that could affect these guys? I mean, obviously, not much is affecting these guys.
Right.
Could it affect your line of vision?
I never noticed it today when I was shooting, and the wind's about the same as my last round was, and I never noticed it blowing. It's actually strung pretty tight, but...
Maybe it's just from the view that we have up here
we can see it moving.
They can't.
Yes. I think that's probably more of it, because I was up here the other day watching targets, and I seen it moving, but when we went down there, I never saw it move.
Okay. Two more to go. And 2 points separating Liptak from Alipov.
But my eyes were always above that, so I don't. I usually hold my eyes up in the alfalfa there.
Okay.
And maybe they do the same, I don't know.
Something you're more comfortable with looking at, huh?
Yeah.
All right, so if you can nail this, the bronze is going to be for Alipov.
There you go.
He's already won the bronze, so we're just going to finish this off with one target each.
Yeah, he's been very solid since the first pass of the semi.
He certainly has. You know, you definitely have to take your hat off to someone like this. He had a great semifinal, made it into the bronze medal match, and just had a couple misses there, but unfortunately a couple misses is enough to end you up in fourth place.
No burn? No.
Finishing off perfect, 15 out of 15 for Alexei Alipov. He will be going home with the bronze medal today. He really just showed what his talent is all about. He is really amazing shooter. Alexei Alipov from the Russian Federation going home with the bronze medal today. And let's just see if we can take a look at our fourth place. We have Yuri Liptak from the Czech Republic going home in fourth place. He did an amazing job shooting today. Unfortunately, it just was not enough, but he will be ending up in fourth place. So now, Seth, we're going to be moving on to the gold medal match. Mm-hmm. Now, these guys have had a little bit of time now to cool down. How do you think that affects the shooting?
You got to go get your mind right again. I mean, yeah, they were definitely geared up to shoot the semifinal, and they both did a very good job of it, and got to go back and reflect and get ready to go out and do it again. And Glasnevich shot an excellent round. He looked solid and he looked very confident and motivated. So and Varga looked the same. He just let the last one get away. So I think it's going to be a great gold medal match.
Now, the next time when you make it into a semifinal and into a gold medal match, would you be inclined to watch the bronze medal match while you're waiting for your gold medal match?
That's a good question, Hillary. I don't know if they did or not, but
okay.
I mean, it sure did root on the fellow shooters, or unless I got to go get ammunition or use a restroom or get water, but I should have all that with me.
No, I'm just curious, out of a mental point of view, is if you just want to shut down and be by yourself, listen to music, or maybe just it'd be more distracting or better for your mind just to watch what was going on.
In my case, I would have probably watched it.
Okay, all right. So it looks like we're going to get the gold medal match started up pretty soon.
Everybody's different, though, so I can't speak for them.
This is the cool thing about watching this sport is that you'll see some people, like if it's during a shoot-off, that some of the shooters will not watch what happens. They'll have their back to... Okay, we got this going on with Glasnevich starting off with a hit. Also for Varga. Now this is one medal match that could go on for quite a long time, but you never know.
Could.
They both seem extremely confident. And like you're saying, Glasnevich, Seth seems like he's really in the zone. He seems like he's really
very
focused. Nice.
That was a great move. They're both looking real solid.
Now Glasnevich has never won a gold medal during the World Cup before. He's won a silver, and although I have to say that Varga has won the gold, that was back in 2007, so I'm pretty sure he's pretty hungry for another one.
Yes. And you said Glasnevich was silver was in 2010?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So they both have,
it's been a few years.
So
it looks like training is definitely paying off, and back on now to Varga. Cool. Okay.
Yeah, that was Josip the one in the Olympic final, or was it his brother Anton?
I need to take a look at that.
I should have looked.
That's all right. No, he was he placed fifth in Beijing in the Olympic Games.
Okay.
In the 2008. So I believe it was his brother that made it.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Call me ma'am again, aren't you?
Oh, sorry.
3 out of 3. We are neck to neck. Back on now to Glasnevich.
Both look great. Outstanding.
These guys are making it look really easy. You know, I've tried it out before and ended up with an extremely bruised shoulder. And I couldn't get over how small that the clays look when you're shooting at them. I mean, from where we are, when I'm commentating even below, whatever, they look like they're quite large, you know?
Right.
And then you start shooting at them and they look like they're the size of like a dime.
Well, they're getting smaller by the moment with this light. But
oops.
Oh. Glasnevich.
Mr. Glasnevich.
This particular range is a beautiful range. You can see the target very well here. It always looks big to me.
Okay.
I mean, almost scary you coming out. It's so big with all the green. But cause you to be a little jumpy from the get-go sometimes.
Okay, so we have now Glasnevich down by one. Varga has seen his door of opportunity open, and let's just see if Glasnevich can just stay in the zone. Nice. We're still really early into this gold medal match. Things can change around. But it looks like Varga's not going to let his guard down.
Shooting very, very good.
So we've got 9 more targets to find out who's going to be on the highest step of the podium. It's really anybody's game at this point. And unfortunately, miss from Glasnevich has put just a little hiccup in his gold medal match, but we'll just have to see how the whole thing plays out.
It's still early. Mm-hmm. Anything can happen.
Oh, yeah, I can go down to the very last target before you know what's happening.
Not to bring any bad things up, but Varga missed his last target out in the semi.
Right.
So he's looking real solid. I mean, between them, they've only missed one since all this started.
That's true.
Yep. So they're shooting very well.
Nice. Yeah, it just looks like Glasnevich just had that little blip in the middle there, and he's back on track. Again on to Vart. Nice.
Excuse me.
No problem. Okay, going on now to shot 9. Just had a little bit of a gust of wind pull through here. That does
great
not
move.
Affect him at all. So right now you can see that the powder is from the targets has just moved off the field of play in a matter of seconds.
The The wind is really coming from the left to the right.
We've got six more to go, and Glasnovic is down by one under Varga. It's not even worth betting for because it's just they're both shooting so incredibly well that you just, you know, of course Varga is no doubt lined up in his mind, just keep on going, keep pumping him out. You know, not only this, but the athletes know exactly where they're standing because we've got a presentator now who
right.
is announcing after every three shots.
Right.
And this is a new thing for shotgun.
That adds a new aspect
to it. It does. It puts, I think, a lot of pressure on you all.
Oh, there
you go. And now we are tied up 9-9. So Glasnovic must be taking a deep sigh of breath of relief right now, saying,
it's
okay,
a whole new ball game.
That's right.
I think they're, in the past, you probably knew where you were at anyway.
Right.
I mean, I did, so, but it just depends on what you want to pay attention to, I guess.
What you want to believe.
Right.
Okay, we're going out at 9-9. Glasnovic has just seen his door of opportunity open up, has nailed that target squarely, and now back onto Varga. Let's see if that miss has what affected his next shot. Absolutely not.
Outstanding move. The presentator does make it more up in your face, so.
It does. Okay, 10-10, Glasnovic and Varga.
It's been an outstanding match. Continues. Looks like Glasnovic is, they're both shooting very solid. I mean,
they really are. Great. With three more targets to go, we have these gentlemen tied up 11-11. Glasnovic is back in the game after that miss from Varga. Three more to go. Anything could happen. This will take us down to the very last target to see who's going to be on the highest step of the podium.
You're getting ready to ask me to make a bet, aren't you?
I am.
I've watched some of your commentary before.
Who's your money on, Seth?
I don't know. I'm going to go with Glasnovic.
All right. Okay.
All right.
Let's see.
Hopefully I didn't curse him right now. He'd be mad at me. Even though he doesn't really know me, but.
he can find you.
Yeah.
All right. Glasnovic clearing that target without a problem and now moving on to Varga.
They're both great shooters. It's hard to say, but.
Two more to go, 12-12. We may be going into a sudden death shoot-off. That's a lot of shooting for one day, you know?
Yes, it is.
But probably worth every penny of ammunition that you use.
Yes.
If you end up on the highest step of the podium, why not?
Absolutely.
Okay. Hitting that squarely. Back onto Varga. Two more to go.
Good shot. That one was climbing.
Last shot. It's going to be right down to this one to find out if we're going to be going into a sudden death shoot-off for the gold medal. And of course, both of these guys want the gold without a doubt, but they'll both be going home with a World Cup medal.
Right.
Which is assuring, without a doubt.
It's always good to go home with some hardware.
Let's focus in now on Glasnovic.
There you go.
And let's see, Varga during the semifinal, he lost his, or missed his last shot. Let's see how he does here.
He got it.
So, in fact, Seth, we're going to be going into a sudden death shoot-off between Glasnovic and Varga. Both of them very sportsmanlike, shaking each other's hands, and we'll just have to wait until we get this going. Here we go, filling up with ammunition right now.
Getting a drink of water and some ammo and do it again.
So the heat here didn't bother you today and yesterday?
No.
No.
The it's It's not as much humidity as South Georgia, so.
This is true. Fort Benning, I was actually really surprised. When you guys were doing your selection match, we were there covering the rifle and pistol events. And generally, it's a place that I'm not thrilled to go to just because of the weather. You know, the people are fantastic. The people are really lovely, but humidity is not my scene. And it was perfect. It was absolutely gorgeous weather. Unseasonably cool, so it was great. Okay, so here we go. We're starting this off. Glasnovich with a hit. Now, if you were to go into a shoot-off, would you prefer to be shooting first or second?
First,
okay.
You're always putting pressure on the second guy. That's just my personal opinion about it.
Well, generally, when we have shoot-offs, I ask my guest commentator which one that they like, and I'm getting about 50-50.
Okay.
Maybe it's more 60-40.
They like to be second?
They like to be first.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, just like you.
Less to think about, I guess. I don't know. it's less pressure.
But the thing is, if you start off or if you miss first, then you have to be mentally really strong to
recover.
Say, okay, it's not over, because you never know what's going to happen after you.
Absolutely. I've gotten a few of them for selection matches and national championships, and I always generally like going first. And some of them have gone 15-14 shots.
Wow.
It's a I believe I was first most of the times that I've succeeded.
Hence the reason why you like to go first.
Right.
Again, back on to Glasnovich.
He's really put together a good string of rounds here. He shot well in his last two rounds and. They both have, but
they really have, but they're not letting down their guard, that's for sure.
This could take a while.
Okay, the wind is picking up right now. Right before Glasnovich takes a shot, and that's not affecting him at all.
Hammered it.
Vargas is falling in his footsteps.
Nothing seems to be phasing him.
No, it really doesn't.
The wind, the lights changing every minute. I noticed they are taking a little bit more time. At least Glasnovich is with his routine, it seems to be. Just a little bit more time, but.
And would you say that's something normal?
Probably.
Yeah. And on to Glasnovich. Yeah, we're having some gusts right now, and really, it's amazing how this is not bothering them at all.
Yeah, it's really blowing out. And they're just in the groove.
In the groove, 5 out of 5. And this is what we see happens. A shoot-off gets underway, and there's only two people in it, let's say. It just starts to have a rhythm to it, and you just know, you can sense it when it happens. It clicks, there's a rhythm, and you think, okay, we're going to be here for a while.
Oh, they're both moving the gun beautifully and pinning any hiccups. We could be here for quite a long time.
Nice.
Move.
Back on now to Varga. Pressure's on. On that hit. Holding up to the pressure without a problem. 6 out of 6 for the gentleman right now. Now you can see here the shadow, actually.
Yes.
That you were talking about before.
It's starting to cast over more.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't over the first camera there earlier, now it is, so.
And that was only, what, 10 minutes, 15 minutes ago?
Right. At least it's not on the bunker. If it was on the bunker, it'd be, I don't know if it's going to create much of a problem back there.
Once again, Glasnovich just nailing that target. Another hit for Fargo. You are right, though. He really has slowed down from considerably.
From the semi, yes.
7-7. There's 8-4. Glasnevich.
I think he's got about the same speed he had in the gold medal match as far as routine, but it seems a little bit slower than the semi.
8 out of 8 for the gentleman now.
They might have to go get more ammunition. What's the longest one you've seen go, Hillary, since you've been commentating with the one shot?
For the one shot, I want to say that it was in Serbia. And I think it was either Glenn Eller or Josh Richmond, but it was for Double Trap. No, it went on forever and ever. And
that
was
Glenn.
It was before the finals, after qualifications to get into it.
One of my teammates back home.
Yeah. Good guy.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Good guy who's quit smoking.
Yes, yes, he's got him some new things here, the electronics.
Well, it's working for him, yes. So that's great.
Yeah, he's a good friend of mine.
9 out of 9 back on now to Glasnevich.
That's good for him that he quit the smoking.
Yeah, but, yep. So.
Tough to quit.
Nice.
Man, they are just continuing.
10 for 10. Again, back on out of Glasnevich.
Excellent.
I think we're going to have to have a little bit of contact with the bus drivers and the bus schedule and say, you know what, can you put off departure time for maybe another half hour?
Well, I think they're supposed to leave at 7, so
we still have some time.
We got an hour. But who knows?
That's
right. The rate they're going.
Yesterday during Trap Woman, we had a really long shoot-off as well. And granted, the bus comes in an hour, but we still have an award ceremony
right,
to do.
Right.
Again, on Tavarga with a hit. 12 out of 12 at the moment. Okay, let's have a little bet here, Seth. How far are they going to get?
The rate they're going, I don't think it'll go past 20.
Okay.
Ooh. Ooh, I just cursed my man.
It's not over yet.
It's not over
you
yet.
You never know.
Right. That's why I like being in that position. We'll see. Oh.
And now it is. It is over. That was quite a shoot-off. Here he is, our gold medalist, Glasnevich.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry, Varga. Sorry, thank you so much. Eric Varga winning the gold medal after an extremely long shoot-off. Really great job shooting. I mean, both of these guys were just unbelievable today.
That's fantastic shooting.
And let's just see if we can take a look at it. There he is, our silver medalist, Josip Glasnevich, winning the silver. Unfortunate target got away from him, but he will be going home on the podium, winning the silver medal. Seth, I want to thank you so much for jumping off that fence and being with me today. I wish you all the best of luck for the future.
Well, thank you for having me. I hope I did a well enough job. I mean, I had some big shoes to fill with some guys that have done this before, but thanks for having me, and it was great shooting here in the people of Cyprus have been great, and thanks for having me again, and great shooting to those guys. So
best of luck to you, okay?
Thank you, ma'am.
First of all, ladies and gentlemen, will you please welcome your medalists? The medals will be presented by Mr. Orianios Ioannidis, the President of the Cyprus Olympic Committee. He is accompanied by Mr. Lakis Simolovitis, President of the Organizing Committee of the Nicosia World Cup 2013. Your bronze medalist, representing the Russian Federation, Alexei Alipov.
Thank you.